Byron, can you give us an update on Kobe?
Kobe's fine. You know, we'll see how he feels tomorrow. You know, we gave him the day off, completely day off. No treatment, no nothing. I just wanted him to stay home. You know, so we'll see him here tomorrow morning. And then we'll just go from there, see how he feels.
Update on Larry Nance Jr.?
Did a little bit today. As far as getting up and down, I didn't like what I saw. You know, he was limping a little bit, so he'll probably be doubtful for tomorrow.
You know, we're watching these games be in. We see good effort, but the wins are sparse. Mm-hmm. What's the improvement that you're seeing?
Well, I mean, like you said, the effort has been much better. I mean, our guys playing hard. You know, that's a given. You know, so that's one thing that I'm very pleased about. But the mistakes that we're making on the defensive end, the transition baskets that we're giving up, you know, we went back to basic stuff today. And those are two areas that we got to get much better at, along with the defensive rebounding. You know, we gave up two offensive rebounds off of free throws last night. And it's just, to me, at that time, that's a little bit of a lack of focus. So, like I said to our guys today, you know, we're going to continue to work on those things until we show improvement, you know, our transition defense. And on our defensive end, as far as paint scores, we got to do a much better job of not allowing people to just drive down the paint. And then rebounding the ball.
You and I have always talked about the little things. You can't have big right. things unless you do the little things. What are the little things that you're really emphasizing in this home stretch?
Well, like I just said, Coach, you know, really getting back in transition, you know, playing defense from inside out, challenging shots, not ball watching. You know, our weak side help has to get better. Our individual defense has to get better. All the little things, you know, because all those little things turn into big things at the end of the day. So we're really concentrating and focusing on all the little things. I'm happy with the progress our young guys are making, but now I want to see it, you know, take another step forward.
You have kind of a unique relationship with Kobe, and since you've known him for 20 years, but mm-hmm. can you imagine coaching a guy for 19 seasons straight through his entire career?
Can I imagine it? No, not in this day and age. You know, I can't imagine it. Has Pop done that?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you know, he's had those three guys together for, I don't know, 15, 16, 17 years, and that's, you know, that's amazing within itself. So, again, the stability of that organization, you know, says a lot about, you know, why they've been so successful as well. You know, they've kept those three guys around, and they've just added talent around them for years and years and years, and those guys just never seem to skip a beat.
The coaching carousel being what it is, and a lot of organizations having kind of a short leash with coaches, what gets lost in terms of the relationships that get built between Pop and Tim in the early days of coaching down 19 years?
Well, I think just that, Bill. Just it gets lost. You know, relationships that you try to build from a coaching standpoint that relates to your players, you know, and if you do it, you know, I mean, he's obviously had that relationship with those guys for 15 plus years, so it's special, you know, but a lot of coaches just don't get that opportunity, you know, to build that type of bond or that type of relationship with their players because, like you said, most of the time it's a very short leash, you know, so obviously he's been very blessed to be put in that position, to have the guys that he's been able to deal with. And Tim is probably like no other superstar in this league as far as, you know, his credentials and what he's been able to accomplish and what he's been able to do. But just how down to earth he is and how easy it is to probably coach him. You know, he takes the criticism. I've seen Pop jump up and yell and scream at him. And, you know, Tim is so mild-mannered, he just walks off and, you know, yeah, it's kind of like, I hear you, Coach. You know, I hear you, you're right. And they've had that relationship for years, and it seems to work extremely well for them.
Hey, Byron, they're going to announce the starters for the All-Star game, so obviously Trevor's going to be one of them. Were you surprised at just the vast amount of votes he got? I mean, obviously he's popular, he's done a lot, but just how overwhelming the votes
are? Yeah, no. You know, just a little bit surprised, but like I said, you know, once I think about it, and I think, once the fans, you know, really thought about it, it's just showing their love and their respect for one of the greatest that ever played the game. And, you know, and I think it's special that he goes out this way, being the leading vote getter, and it's not even close. You know, it says a lot about what he's been able to do over his career. And as much as people try to vilify him early and all the other stuff that he's gone through, I think at the end of the day, they're showing that, again, that he is definitely one of the greatest to ever play the game, and they're showing their respects because of the way that he approached the game.